Proxies act as a gateway that sit between you and the internet and can be used to control access to websites within a local network. They can also be used to hide your public IP address when accessing a website because the request will come from the proxy server's IP address. In addition, the proxy server can act as a firewall on a network or function as a web filter. A benefit of a proxy is the ability to cache data to speed up common HTTP requests, which result in faster load times. To set up a proxy using the requests library, we will first import requests. Next, we will set up a dictionary called proxies. Within this dictionary, we can set up a proxy server URL to route traffic through when requests are made using different schemes such as HTTP and HTTPS. To find a proxy server to demonstrate this call, we will go to freeproxylist.net, which provides us with a proxy server to send a request through. In practice, this proxy server would be controlled by your organization, but we will use this for demonstration. For the HTTPS scheme, let's route the traffic through the proxy server. Now we can create a response object R and set this equal to request.get. Within the get function, we will add the URL httpbin.org/IP, which is an endpoint set up by httpbin that will return the origin IP address of the requester. Following the URL, we will add the keyword proxies with the value proxies, which is the dictionary we created. This URL is using the HTTPS scheme, so it will use the corresponding proxy defined in the proxy dictionary. When the text from the response object is printed to the console, we can see the origin IP address matches the IP address of the proxy server we set up. We can also define a proxy server to route through when a request is made using a particular scheme and hostname. To do this, we will add a hostname of httpbin.org after the HTTPS scheme in the proxy's dictionary. Now when a request is made to the httpbin.org hostname using the HTTPS scheme, the request will be sent through the proxy server. For more Python tutorials, like, share, and subscribe to the PyPros channel.